Good evening class, we were on the chapter that was body fluid in circulation and today we will be completing this chapter. First of all we are going to discuss about that is the systole and the diastole today. Systole and diastole that we had discussed before also. As we had completed the cardiac cycle and the ECG which was related to this systole and diastole only. So we will be starting with the systolic and the diastolic pressure. Systolic and the diastolic pressure. And then we will going to start with the portal system. Good evening Sam, good evening. Good evening. First of all, systolic pressure and then the diastolic pressure. Good evening, Sachin. So I told you the systolic is the contraction and diastolic is the relaxation. So systolic pressure is the pressure which is exerted on the walls of the blood vessels at the end of the systolic contraction. Blood vessels are what? These are the arteries, these are the veins. So systolic pressure is the pressure exerted. Do you remember 120 by 80 mm of Hg of the mercury? So we are discussing about this only today. Okay, so this systolic pressure. Okay, now systolic contraction happens and which will be noted will be that will be the ventricular contraction, ventricular systole or the ventricular contraction will be measured. Okay, systole and diastole. Sachin, I just want to know that the pressure over here, that is the ventricular systole which I am seeing of the blood pressure, will be of arteries and veins. It will be both or only arteries. This question goes to Sachin. Next is the diastolic pressure. Diastolic pressure is the pressure which the blood exert on the walls of the blood vessels when the ventricles are diastole or we can say as relaxed. Ventricles are relaxed. Okay. And that is 120 by 80 mm of Hg. Sachin, have you got the answers? मैं जो इसमें blood vessels की बात कर रही हूँ, so इसमें blood vessels क्या सब आएंगी? That is arteries, vein, capillaries, everything will come over here. Everything will come over here. Next question goes to Sam. What is the instrument used to measure blood pressure? This is a question of class 10th. Okay, I suppose that you will write the correct spelling of it, Sam. So the question goes to Sachin and Sam. Okay, related to it, next we will start with that is a hypertension and hypotension. Hypertension and hypotension. Hypertension and hypotension. Manometer, no Sachin. First of all, Sachin, this question was to Sam. And Sachin, I had asked you, ma'am, what the question? Sam, the question is that what is the instrument used to measure the blood pressure? And Sachin, to you, the question is ki maine aapko bhi systolic pressure ki aur diastolic pressure ki abhi definition batai hai, theek hai? And in this definition, I am saying that in the systolic pressure is the pressure which the blood is exerting on the blood vessels, on the walls of the blood vessels at the time of ventricular systole. So what is that blood vessel which I am talking about? Okay, so this is the, these are the questions which, yes. Yes, you have written the right spelling of exam. Yes, it is right. Sphygmomanometer. Sphygmomanometer is the instrument used to measure the BP. Okay. Now we come. Sachin, I am waiting for your answer still. Now, hypertension and hypotension. Okay. Hypertension, when this reading will be approx 150 by 90 means above, and it will be low. Hypotension and hypertension, जिसको कि हम high BP और low BP भी कहते हैं, ठीक है? Hypertension is a bit risky, but hypotension generally leads to a person generally faint. But hypertension is risky. Today we'll also discuss about the abnormalities related to it. After the blood pressure, you also feel the pulse rate. So we are going to discuss the next topic is pulse. Sachin, blood vessels and also the portal system. Also the portal system. Okay. So next is the pulse. That answer is arteries. Next question. Next question, Sachin. Now pulse. Where do you feel the pulse? Pulse rate. Where do you feel the pulse? Okay. Generally the pulse is felt on the temporal region. Artery. Yes, Sachin. Yes, Sachin. It is artery only. Okay. Now, it is generally felt on the temporal artery, which is present on the temporal bone. Okay. This pulse. And yes, it is right, Sachin. Okay. Now, a pulse is felt due to the contraction, pulse is generally felt due to the contraction of the left ventricle. Contraction means systole, that is the ventricular systole that we generally feel. Okay. And this ventricular systole, which pumps about 70 to 90 ml of blood. One. Okay. I hope so that this is clear to everyone. This is clear to everyone. Should I move forward? Okay. Next is cardiac output. Next topic is cardiac output. Cardiac output ka simple sa formula hota hai, and that is stroke volume into heart beat. Stroke volume into heart beat. Okay. Now, what is the normal heartbeat? What is the normal heartbeat? Sachin, can you tell me? We have discussed this also, the total cardiac output, when we were talking about the we have discussed about the cardiac cycle. Over there we had discussed about it. Heartbeat is the number of times the heart is beating, okay, in 1 minute. Heartbeat means heart is beating per minute. What is that? 5 liter. Yes, cardiac output is 5 liter. It is approx 5 liter. That time also Sam has given. Good evening, Pratham. Good evening. Okay. And what is the stroke volume? Stroke volume is the blood which is ejected out during the ventricular contraction or ventricular systole. Okay. There is also another, that is about 70 to 75, and there is one another formula to calculate this कार्डियक आउटपुट विच आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस विद यू टुडे, तभी मैंने इसको रिपीट किया है कार्डियक आउटपुट को, ये तो मैंने डिस्कस कर लिया था दैट स्ट्रोक वॉल्यूम इनटू हार्ट बीट. ठीक है, सो द अनदर फॉर्मूला फॉर इट दैट इज ईडीवी, ईडीवी माइनस ईएसवी. ये क्या होता है, व्हाट इज ईडीवी? ओके, ईडीवी इज एंड इज दिस साइड विजिबल टू एवरीवन? Good evening, Gayatri. We all are discussing about the cardiac output. Cardiac output is stroke volume into heartbeat. Heartbeat is the number of times the heart is beating per minute, and stroke volume is the volume of the blood pumped in the ventricular systole. And we are discussing about one another formula, that is EDV minus ESV. Okay. Now, EDV stands for end diastole volume minus end systole volume. You can note it down. End diastole volume minus end systole volume. Okay, means relaxed. What it means? It means diastole means relaxed, means relaxed ventricle volume minus contracted ventricular volume. Relaxed ventricular volume minus the contracted ventricular volume, and that is 70 into 75 इसको करते हैं हम. ठीक है, and that is 5250 approx 5 liter. This is the कार्डियक आउटपुट. शॉर्ट नोट, ये आता है 130 माइनस 60. सॉरी, इसको इससे मत कोरिलेट कर देना. ठीक है, इट इज 130 माइनस 60. ओके, नेक्स्ट वी कम टू नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज दैट इज द पोर्टल सिस्टम. पोर्टल सिस्टम, is this clear to everyone? Cardiac output. Portal system. Have you all heard about the hepatic portal system? किसी ने hepatic portal system word सुना है? Hepatic portal system. Any one of you heard about the hepatic portal system? Yes, Sam has. Sam, Sachin, Pratham has heard about the hepatic portal system. Okay. Now in NCERT about the portal system, it has been written that a unique vascular connection which exists between the digestive tract and the liver. Iske beech mein there occurs a portal, a unique vascular system. A unique vascular system occurs. These are exactly the lines of the NCERT, and which is called as the hepatic portal system. ठीक है, लेकिन इसका function क्या होता है? Gayatri is asking me, ma'am, which page number? That I have to search. I remember कि double circulation की heading में है शायद बेटा. I don't know exactly the page number, but it is under the heading of double circulation. जहाँ पे double circulation define किया गया है, उसमें systemic और pulmonary circulation में जो दोनों में difference है, वहाँ पे ही these exact lines are given for the hepatic portal system. Okay. So I wanted to tell you about this hepatic portal system. कि hepatic portal system ये होता क्या है? ठीक है? Generally in humans, ठीक है, दो टाइप के पोर्टल सिस्टम प्रेजेंट होते हैं, दैट इज एक होता है हिपैटिक पोर्टल सिस्टम और एक होता है हाइपोफाइसियल पोर्टल सिस्टम। प्लीज नोट इट डाउन कि ह्यूमंस में सिर्फ दो ही पोर्टल सिस्टम प्रेजेंट होते हैं। ओके ओके सैम, सैम हैज हेल्प गायत्री, दैट इज ऑन पेज नंबर 256। ओके, दैट हिपैटिक पोर्टल सिस्टम और हाइपोफाइसियल पोर्टल सिस्टम ही प्रेजेंट होता है, रीनल पोर्टल सिस्टम मैमल्स में नहीं प्रेजेंट होता है। आई जस्ट टेल यू, ठीक है, आई जस्ट टेल यू दैट इट इज एब्सेंट इन मैमल्स और ह्यूमंस में दो ही पोर्टल सिस्टम प्रेजेंट होते हैं। ठीक है, नाउ व्हाट इज दिस फंक्शन ऑफ दिस हिपैटिक पोर्टल सिस्टम एंड व्हाट इज द फंक्शन ऑफ द हाइपोफाइसियल पोर्टल सिस्टम। हिपैटिक आपके सिलेबस में एनसीईआरटी में इसी चैप्टर में डबल सर्कुलेशन में दिया हुआ है, हाइपोफाइसियल नहीं दिया हुआ है, बट आई होप सो दैट दिस विल बी नॉट बी सो मच एक्स्ट्रा फॉर यू, सो दैट सो आई थॉट टू एक्सप्लेन यू। यहाँ पे हिपैटिक पोर्टल सिस्टम जो कर रहा है, ठीक है, वो क्या कर रहा है, न्यूट्रिएंट रिच डीऑक्सीजनेटेड ब्लड, यहां से न्यूट्रिएंट रिच डीऑक्सीजनेटेड ब्लड फ्रॉम हियर, न्यूट्रिएंट रिच डीऑक्सीजनेटेड ब्लड फ्रॉम गट टू लिवर। ठीक है, और ऐसा क्यों हो रहा है, लिवर का सबसे इंपॉर्टेंट फंक्शन क्या है, जो हमने एक्सक्रीटरी सिस्टम में पढ़ा था, जो हमने स्टार्टिंग में पढ़ा था, तो लिवर का मेन फंक्शन था डीएमिनेशन एंड डिटॉक्सिफिकेशन, डीएमिनेशन एंड डिटॉक्सिफिकेशन। ठीक है, अब वो कैसे होगा, जो यहाँ पे न्यूट्रिएंट रिच डीऑक्सीजनेटेड ब्लड जो डाइजेस्टिव ट्रैक में है, गट में है, यहाँ से लिवर में जाएगा, पोर्टल सिस्टम हेल्प करेगा और फिर यहाँ से क्या होगा, इट इज गोइंग टू डू द डीएमिनेशन डिटॉक्सिफिकेशन, दैट इज द एक्सेस ऑफ अमीनो एसिड विल बी कन्वर्टेड इनटू यूरिया। ठीक है, अगेन पोर्टल सिस्टम होता क्या है, पोर्टल सिस्टम दो ऑर्गन्स को कनेक्ट कर रहा है। ठीक है, जनरली आर्टरी और वेन्स हमने सुनी है, आर्टरीज क्या करती है, ब्लड किसी ऑर्गन, दे टेक द ब्लड टू एनी ऑर्गन। ठीक है, एंड आर्टरी जनरली टेक्स द ऑक्सीजनेटेड ब्लड एक्सेप्ट द पल्मोनरी आर्टरी व्हिच हैज गॉट द डीऑक्सीजनेटेड ब्लड। ठीक है, नेक्स्ट वेन क्या होती है, वो ऑर्गन से डीऑक्सीजनेटेड ब्लड लेकर जाती है, पल्मोनरी वेन इज द ओनली वेन विच हैज गॉट द ऑक्सीजनेटेड ब्लड। ठीक है, ये इसलिए डिफरेंस है क्योंकि आर्टरी और वेन की जो डेफिनेशन होती है वो होती है विच इज टेकिंग टूवर्ड्स ऑर्गन विच इज टेकिंग अवे। ठीक है, तो उसके लिए यहाँ पे आर्टरी और वेन दोनों में डिफरेंस ऑक्सीजनेशन और डीऑक्सीजनेशन का। सेकेंड, ब्लड प्रेशर पल्मोनरी आर्टरी में सबसे ज्यादा होता है, देन पल्मोनरी आर्टरी में ज्यादा होता है, देन पल्मोनरी वेन। ठीक, नेक्स्ट पोर्टल सिस्टम यहाँ पे डाइजेस्टिव ट्रैक में, यहाँ से पोर्टल सिस्टम इज गोइंग टू टेक द ब्लड फ्रॉम द डाइजेस्टिव ट्रैक फ्रॉम द गट टू द लिवर फॉर द डिटॉक्सिफिकेशन फॉर द डीएमिनेशन एंड डिटॉक्सिफिकेशन डीएमिनेशन सो दैट द एक्सेस अमीनो एसिड इज कन्वर्टेड इनटू यूरिया। इज दिस क्लियर टू एवरीवन, इज दिस क्लियर टू एवरीवन? हिपैटिक पोर्टल सिस्टम पे अगर शॉर्ट नोट आएगा विल यू एबल टू राइट इट डाउन everyone? Is this clear to everyone? Should I move on to the second portal system, that is the hypophysial portal system? Hypophysial portal system present hota hai pituitary gland ke paas. ठीक है, pituitary gland में अगर हमने endocrine system नहीं भी पढ़ा है, endocrine system नहीं भी पढ़ा है हमने, तो हमने excretory products and elimination में pituitary glands के par nervosa region का ADH बढ़ रखा है, that is anti-diuretic hormone, ठीक है, and that anti-diuretic hormone is secreted by the, ठीक है, hypothalamus region। तो ये जो pituitary gland होता है, यहाँ पे जो portal system present होता है, It helps in regulation on the amount of hormone which has to be secreted. ठीक है, जैसे कि बहुत से ऐसे hormones होते हैं which is dependent on the concentration of the blood, on the requirement of the blood. This statement, मैंने ये statement बहुत बार बोला है excretory product and elimination में पढ़ाते टाइम कि बहुत it depends on the concentration, it depends on the requirement. ठीक है, so exactly this will be measured by there, over there the concentration and the hormones will be released. So over there this hypophyseal portal system is present. This is not given in your NCERT. I very well know this. Okay, now we come to the double circulation. I know double circulation आपने पढ़ा है class 10th में, but we are going to draw the diagrammatic sketch of it. Okay, sometimes we are very overconfident that yes we know. Okay, so do make with me, make it with me, okay, and then send me a pic so I will check it out. Okay, now right ventricle, I'm starting with the right ventricle. ठीक है, right ventricle deoxygenated blood from pulmonary artery it is going where? Pulmonary artery it is. Ma'am, I didn't understand the hypophyseal portal system. Okay, Gayatri, I'm repeating it again. Hypophyseal portal system pituitary gland के पास present होता है, जैसे कि hepatic portal system is between the digestive tract and the liver. ठीक है, क्योंकि the pituitary gland which is secreting the hormone, so over there the portal system is going to just check for the concentration of blood and as per the requirement of the body. Like suppose for example the ADH which you have ADH that you have studied in excretory products and elimination chapter, over there ADH is also secreted from the pars nervosa region, renin bhi hai wahan pe. Theek hai, so all this which is secreted over there, so that is being checked by over that portal system which helps in the regulation. That's it. Okay, next we are coming to the double circulation. And double circulation in humans, the double circulation is that is systemic and pulmonary. So we are going to just see over here what it is. Right ventricle se, you are going to make it with me. Everyone in your notebook, you are going to make it with me. Okay. Deoxygenated blood to the pulmonary artery to the lungs. Lungs se kahan ho jayega? It is going to go pulmonary vein. Pulmonary vein से कहाँ आएगा? It is going to come towards the left auricle. It is going to come towards the left auricle over here. Okay. After left auricle towards the left ventricle, it will come to the left ventricle. Left ventricle, it will have the oxygenated blood. Yes, oxygenated blood. And to the aorta, left ventricle to the aorta to the body part, aorta to the body part, all body parts except lungs over here. Okay, and then with the vena cava, inferior vena cava and the superior vena cava is going to pump the blood to the right auricle and then to the right ventricle. Okay, so from here to here it is pulmonary circulation and over here it is systemic circulation. Few of you say it as systematic nahi hai, ye systemic hai, pure system ko there is circulation going on, that's why. Okay, is this clear to everyone? Should I proceed now? Ma'am, the board is shining near lungs. बेटा लंग्स से जाएगा पल्मोनरी वेन, लंग्स से जाएगा पल्मोनरी वेन से फिर कहाँ आएगा? इट विल कम ओवर हियर द लेफ्ट ऑरिकल से इट इज गोइंग टू कम टुवर्ड्स द लेफ्ट वेंट्रिकल से एओर्टा जाएगा, एओर्टा से टू द बॉडी पार्ट्स जाएगा. ओके, आई विल अवॉइड राइटिंग इन दैट रीजन, इफ इट इज सो आई एम गोइंग टू अवॉइड देयर. ओके, so have you all completed it? Should I proceed? Okay, so the next topic is short note. Do come for the double circulation also, to write the short note on double circulation. बॉडी फ्लूइड्स में बॉडी. ओके, नाउ वी कम टू सर्टेन एबनॉर्मैलिटीज विच कम इन दिस सर्कुलेटरी सिस्टम. ठीक है, कौन कौन सी होती है? हार्ट ब्लॉक, एंजाइना पेन, हाइपरटेंशन. हाइपोटेंशन को हम वी विल नॉट टेक इट एज अ डिजीज. ओके, नेक्स्ट इज हार्ट फेलियर, देन इज कोरोनरी आर्टरी डिजीज, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज द CAD, देन इट इज कोरोनरी थ्रोम्बोसिस. ठीक है, थ्रोम्बस होगा, क्लॉट बनेगा. और एक और हमें यह पढ़ना था, दैट इज फिब्रिलेशन. ये बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है, फिब्रिलेशन क्या होता है. ठीक है, सो दीज ऑल पॉइंट्स वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस टुडे, दैट इज हार्ट ब्लॉक, एंजाइना पेन, हाइपरटेंशन, हार्ट फेलियर, CAD, कोरोनरी थ्रोम्बोसिस एंड फिब्रिलेशन. ओके, नाउ एंजाइना पेक्टोरिस. फर्स्ट इज द एंजाइना पेन. कैसे स्टार्ट होता है? This is the chest pain and it generally occurs in the left side of the body and it also in the left arm. In the left arm, and we see it as the angina pain. Okay, angina pain. This angina pain can be due to this CAD. And this CAD, that is coronary artery disease. अब कहोगे ये मैम coronary artery क्या होती है? ठीक है, coronary artery is the artery which is going to supply blood to the heart. Okay, this is going to supply blood to the heart muscles. Okay, अब कोरोनरी आर्टरी, ये ज्यादातर जो मैंने अभी कंडीशंस बताई हैं, ये ज्यादातर कोरोनरी आर्टरी से ही रिलेटेड है. ओके, व्हेन अ पर्सन डजंट डू एक्सरसाइज एंड दे टेक अ लॉट ऑफ फैट. ओके, सो इनसाइड दिस कोरोनरी आर्टरी फैट डिपोजिशन अकर्स. ठीक है, ये तो खुद करता है आदमी कभी कभी. यस प्रथम, यू आर राइट, ये तो खुद करता है आदमी. ठीक है, मींस ईटिंग द ऑल द जंक फूड्स, पता है कि नहीं अच्छा है लेकिन फिर भी वो खाता है. ठीक है, आई नो दैट इट इज फैटी एसिड्स है, बायो भी पढ़ रखी है, फिर भी. ठीक है, एंड डजंट डू एक्सरसाइज, सो व्हाट विल हैपन, ऑल द कोलेस्ट्रॉल, ऑल द फैट, समटाइम्स कैल्शियम ऑल्सो डिपॉजिट. कभी कभी आदमी की गलती नहीं भी होती है. ठीक है, हमेशा ब्लेम नहीं करना चाहिए. ओके, समटाइम्स कैल्शियम ऑल्सो डिपॉजिट, लेकिन ये डिपॉजिशन भी कम हो सकता है इफ द पर्सन डू द फिजिकल एक्सरसाइज. ओके, सो कोरोनरी आर्टरी डिजीज. अब ये डू यू थिंक सो, इफ द ब्लड दिस ब्लड वेसल इज सप्लाइंग द ब्लड टू द हार्ट and there occurs the fat deposition, cholesterol deposition, don't you think the heart muscles will work slow? कुछ ना कुछ इफेक्ट पड़ेगा ना उन मसल्स पे, ठीक है? और हमारा हार्ट कैसा है? मायोजेनिक हार्ट है, मसल्स पर डिपेंडेंट है, सो इट विल गेट अफेक्टेड. ऑब्वियस ही बात है, इफेक्ट होगा, इट इज गोइंग टू कॉज अ लॉट ऑफ डिजीजेस. ठीक है, दिस इज द ओनली रीजन. गायत्री मैम, पीपल ऑल्सो कंप्लेन अबाउट द चेस्ट पेन बिफोर द कार्डियक अरेस्ट एंड इट इज एंजाइना पेक्टोरिस. यस यू आर राइट, यस यू आर राइट, बट समटाइम्स समटाइम्स ड्यू टू सम एसिडिक कंडीशन ऑल्सो द सेम पेन अकर्स समटाइम्स, बट इट इज रेयर एंड पीपल शुड नोटिस दिस पेन. ओके, एंजाइना पेक्टोरिस, कमिंग बैक, बट यू आर सेइंग बिफोर कार्डियक अरेस्ट, सो इट इज राइट. Now, what will happen? So, this coronary artery will get affected by the deposition of calcium, cholesterol that makes the artery lumen narrower. Okay? Now, next is coronary thrombosis. Thrombus matlab clot hota hai. Thrombus means clot. And so, if a clot occurs in this coronary artery, then also they can occur the heart failure also, and they will also be a pain also, heart block, जिसको हम heart block भी कहते हैं, ठीक है? Sometimes this clot can be dissolved by streptokinase. Streptokinase एक enzyme होता है, जिससे कि ये I will also discuss about angioplasty, ballooning जो होती है. How it is helpful, I'm going to discuss that. Ma'am, is it true that heart attack is a silent or without any pain? It can be silent also, because the deposition will happen. If a person is having the angina pain, okay, or that person is ignoring that, then it will be in the silent only. Finally, it will have the heart attack. So, it will be the silent heart attack, okay. That's why. Now, coming back to this, that is coronary thrombosis. Clot formation hua. Clot formation mein doctor is going to take give prescribe, that is a streptokinase enzyme dega. Streptokinase will try to dissolve this clot. Okay? Either then ya to fir ballooning ke liye, angioplasty ke liye bhi jana ja sakta hai. Okay? So this is all. What is fibrillation? What is fibrillation? Fibrillation is, that is shivering. Fibrillation होता है, जैसे कि sometimes shivering occurs. Rhythmic मतलब जो हम कहेंगे pacemaker, ठीक है? That is the SAN node जो होता है, SAN node which is the pacemaker. SAN, that is the pacemaker of the heart, ठीक है? And AV is the pace setter. Okay? Now sometimes what happens that fibrillation occurs when a person say that my heartbeat is quite मतलब मेरा बहुत heartbeat बहुत तेज हो रही है, ठीक है? So fibrillation sometimes lead to shivering, sometimes lead to irregular conditions that occurs because of this pacemaker irregular rhythm. Rhythm का मतलब क्या हुआ? रिदम का मतलब क्या हुआ? रिदम का मतलब हुआ दैट हार्ट इज नॉट प्रॉपरली वर्किंग, एंड फॉर दैट एन आर्टिफिशियल पेसमेकर इज सेट. ओके, फिब्रिलेशन कैन आल्सो अकर ड्यू टू हाइपरटेंशन, आल्सो कैन आल्सो अकर ड्यू टू हाइपरटेंशन. इज दिस क्लियर टू एवरीवन? इज दिस क्लियर टू एवरीवन? Fibrillation, hypertension, angina, pain, heart block. Okay, next we discuss, now we want to discuss about the bypass surgery and the angioplasty. Okay, fine. Next we are going to discuss about the bypass surgery. Ab puri kachori to bahut kha li hai, theek hai? ब्लॉक भी हो गया है, बट वी हैव टू लीड द लाइफ. ओके, बिकॉज वी वॉन्ट टू लिव. ओके, So doctors have got few remedies, and in that there is one is bypass surgery. Bypass, ma'am, where is it in the NCRT? Gayatri, bypass surgery नहीं है, angioplasty नहीं है. I am just trying to explain you the remedies because only the diseases are given over there. Okay? Because yeah, बहुत you just hear about them, so I thought to discuss with you all. It will take only a short of time. बाईपास सर्जरी होती है जैसे कोरोनरी आर्टरी है, ठीक है. कोरोनरी आर्टरी में देयर अकर्स अ ब्लॉक, ठीक है. सो व्हाट इज गोइंग टू टेक, दे आर गोइंग टू टेक, डॉक्टर्स आर गोइंग टू टेक द वेन, वेन ऑफ द थाई रीजन, ओके. और कहते हैं ना बाईपास, एक रास्ता होता है बाईपास, ठीक है. सो दे आर गोइंग टू मेक अ बाईपास वे. यहाँ पे ब्लॉकेज है, यहाँ पे ट्रैफिक जाम लगा हुआ है, और वो ऐसा जाम लगा हुआ है, ठीक है, ऐसा जाम है जो कि हटने वाला नहीं है. तो बेटर है कि बाईपास को ही हम मेन रास्ता बना लेते हैं. तो ये बाईपास रास्ता हमने बना लिया, दैट इज दी बाईपास सर्जरी, कोरोनरी आर्टरी ब्लॉकेज को ठीक करने के लिए. एंड दिस इज डन बाय द वेन विच इज टेकन बाय दी थायरीजन. My grandfather had the bypass surgery of, okay. Now, another is angioplasty. Angioplasty क्या होती है? ठीक है, angioplasty होती है, एक balloon catheter use करते हैं. Okay. Now, balloon catheter use करते हैं, ठीक है. So, what happens? I have to draw it again. Coronary artery है, deposition हो गया है, काफी deposition हो गया है, ठीक है. So a catheter with a balloon and it has got the helium gas inside and it is pulled with the pressure and when it is going to pull. It is going to take this block. ये जो blockage है, ये भी पीछे, it is also be coming back with it. ठीक है? So coronary artery क्या होगी? Clear हो जाएगी. That is the angioplasty treatment. That is the treatment. Got it? Is this clear to everyone? The treatment. Everyone. We have studied about the regulation of the cardiac activity, the parasympathetic and the parasympathetic both by the ANS, autonomic nervous system. So over here, two ions, उसमें जो hormones होते हैं और ions का regulation होता है, उसमें दो ions का बहुत important role होता है, and that is the potassium and the calcium ions. That is potassium and the calcium ions in the regulation of the heart. Okay, now excess potassium जो होगा, this अगर body में potassium ज़्यादा होगा, okay, so it is going to decrease the heart rate. It is going to decrease the heart rate. Okay, and it is going to force for contraction. Okay. And excess of calcium ion is going to increase the heart rate. So these are the ions which are helpful. Calcium ion is also useful in the clotting of blood, and vitamin K injection is also given during the coagulation if excess bleeding occurs. And the anti-hemophilic factor is absent, then doctors do give vitamin K injection, which is also important in for the coagulation of blood. Okay, and hemophilia is a condition where blood flows excess and no clotting of blood occurs. Is this clear to everyone? Okay, so with this we have completed the chapter CBSE NCERT
Ma'am, is it true now that our chest hurts a lot with every beat for a few years after this surgery? Which surgery, beta? Bypass surgery. Chest hurt. Open heart surgery. Open heart surgery होती है जब तब. Okay, fine. Now, now we are going to discuss the NCRT exercises as we have completed this chapter, that is body fluids in circulation, all from NCRT, a bit extra to make the chapter interesting and to clear your queries. Okay, yes Pratham. Okay, so the first question, open your NCRT books, everyone open your NCRT book. And the first question goes to Gayatri. I have not even seen what is the first question. And the first question goes to Gayatri. Ma'am, what is the difference between the open heart surgery and the bypass surgery? Okay, over there, open heart surgery and the bypass surgery, to maine aapko abhi bata diye kya hai. Theek hai? Open heart surgery is there when valves have to be replaced. Theek hai? Valves जब replace करनी होती हैं, then open heart surgery is done. That's why, ठीक है? The rib cage which is present, it is cut from between, it is open, and then the valves are changed. Okay? Need not to go in that much detail. Coming back, we are still a student, not a surgeon. Okay? So we are starting with the chapter NCRT exercises. Everyone. Let me open my book also. Okay, the first question is, first question goes to Gayatri. Name the components of the formed elements in the blood and mention one major function of each of them. Okay, so it has asked for the formed elements. Formed elements kaun kaun se hote hain, Gayatri? Answer them quickly. That is our, this marker is not working. That is RBC, WBC and platelets. Okay, RBC, that is the red blood cells. Okay, because of the presence of hemoglobin, red pigment is there. WBCs, which is divided into granulocytes, agranulocytes, because of the difference in the cytoplasm. Neutrophils, lymphocytes, basophils, eosinophils are there. Okay, platelets, which are also called as thrombocytes. Next question, what is the importance of plasma protein? Who is going to answer? Sachin, what is the importance of plasma? Yes, okay fine Gayatri. Now plasma mein sabse, plasma protein sabse pehle important hote hain. Sachin, will you answer me? Can you name the proteins which are present in the plasma? Any one of you, the proteins which are present in the plasma, very three important proteins which are present in the plasma. Albumin, globulin, and third is the fibrinogen. Albumin, which is like a solute. Removal of the waste? No, Gayatri, no removal of the waste nahi hoga beta. Ye osmotic pressure ko balance karta hai. It will act as the, it will waste nahi hoga Gayatri. Agar aap foreign elements ki baat kar rahe hain, so it is not waste Gayatri, it is the foreign elements which we say as foreign elements as antigen. Okay, yes Pratham, yes Sachin, fibrinogen, albumin and globulin is there. So albumin osmotic pressure ko balance karta hai, it will act as a solute aur hamari body ke jo water balance hai usko balance karega. Do you remember one question I had asked during when I was teaching it? Yes, in the transportation of the blood cells. Yes, you are right, Pratham. Ye maine question pucha tha. Albumin agar kam hoga to blood volume par kya farak padega? Do you all remember? Globulin. Globulins are the proteins which is going to help in the formation of the anti. Yes, Gayatri, now you are right. That is the removal of the foreign substances. It is right now. Globulin, which are helpful in the formation of the antibodies, and fibrinogen, which is going to help in the formation of the fibrin in the coagulation of the blood. Okay. Yes, Pratham, you are also right. Next, match the following, match the column. All of you have got your NCERT book with you. Sam, where are you? Next question goes to Sam. Okay. Eosinophil. The first is eosinophil. What is the function of eosinophil? Sam, please write it down. Write the answer of it. Eosinophil. Next is RBC. You all have your NCERT book, so I'm not going to write the second part of it. AB blood group. AB blood group. First question goes to Sam. Second question goes to Sachin. Third to Pratham. Platelets. Platelets. And fifth is systole. Fifth is systole. Yes, eosinophil. Yes, Sam. Sam, I am waiting for your answer for this. That is, match the following. Eosinophil. Eosinophil will be what? Resist infection. Eosinophil, which is going to resist infection. One more. It yes, many diya hua hai, Sam. But what is the function? Eosinophil count kab zyada ho jata hai? Only Sam will answer. Eosinophil count may, Sachin, where are you for the second answer? Eosinophil count kab zyada ho jata hai? Theek hai? RBC. Next is the RBC. RBC helps in the, Sachin, where are you? Eosinophil count allergy may, it increases. Theek hai? और इसके लिए हिस्टामिन्स और सीरोटोनिन कौन सीक्रेट करता है? गायत्री विल टेल मी. आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू रिस्ट्रिक्ट टू ओनली एनसीईआरटी एक्सरसाइजेस व्हिच आर गिवन. मैं उसमें से भी क्वेश्चन निकालूंगी. फॉर सचिन, यस, इट इज फॉर द गैस ट्रांसपोर्ट. सिर्फ गैस ट्रांसपोर्ट करता है, सिर्फ गैस ट्रांसपोर्ट करता है सचिन. गायत्री, सीरोटोनिन हिस्टामिन कहां कौन सीक्रेट करता है? व्हिच सेल सीक्रेट हिस्टामिन एंड सीरोटोनिन? मैम, आई डिडंट गेट द क्वेश्चन एंड नाइदर आई डोंट नो द आंसर ऑफ इट. बेटा, आई एम आस्किंग यू, ईसिनोफिल काउंट डज व्हाट? किस कंडीशन में ईसिनोफिल काउंट बढ़ जाता है? एलर्जी में. और इसी से रिलेटेड है हिस्टामिन और सीरोटोनिन, विच इज ऑल्सो सिक्रीटेड बाई दी बैसोफिल सेल्स. डू रिमाइंड द वीडियो एंड गो थ्रू इट अगेन एंड अगेन. ओके, नेक्स्ट इज द एबीओ ब्लड ग्रुप. एबीओ ब्लड ग्रुप इज वॉट? यूनिवर्सल डोनर और यूनिवर्सल रेसिपियंट? एबीओ ब्लड ग्रुप इज यूनिवर्सल रेसिपियंट. प्रथम हैज आंसर्ड दिस. ओके, नेक्स्ट इज प्लेटलेट्स. फॉर प्लेटलेट्स वॉट इट इज गिवेन? Platelets helps in the coagulation. Platelet helps in the coagulation, that is the clotting of the blood. And systole is contraction. Systole is contraction of the heart. Yes. Okay. So a bit about a WBC. WBC, the types of WBC, white blood cells, beta, granulocytes, agranulocytes. Please go through it very carefully. Okay. Now next question. Why do we consider blood as a connective tissue? Why do we consider blood as a connective tissue? Connective tissue because it consists of matrix. It has got the matrix, and second, it has got the corpuscles. It has got the corpuscles in them, and that is why we consider it as a connective tissue. Okay, plasma is there. Blood mein kya hota hai main component? Plasma and corpuscles. Okay class, next question. What is the difference between the lymph and the blood? Theek hai, जैसे ही क्वेश्चन आए वैसे ही इन योर माइंड यू शुड हैव द इमेज ब्लड कैपिलरीज, एक बार रिविजन हो जाए. ब्लड कैपिलरीज है इधर, दीज आर दी ब्लड कैपिलरीज. इन बिटवीन इज द टिश्यू विद द इंटरस्टिशियल फ्लूइड एंड ओवर हियर इज द लिम्फ. ओके, सो ब्लड कैपिलरीज विद द हाइड्रोस्टैटिक प्रेशर व्हाट विल कम? ठीक है, बायो मॉलिक्यूल्स विल कम, आयंस विल कम, पैथोजन विल कम. ओके, सो 100% में से 80% विल कम, 60% विल गो, 20% will reach over here to the lymph. Now, lymph is named so because it is rich in lymphocytes. It is rich in lymphocytes. So, it is going to fight. It has got what? B cells and T cells. Okay? B cells and T cells. T cells, that is a cellular mediated immunity. B cells is a humoral mediated immunity. I told you now, 1-to-1 war and one is there which is going to be with the army. Okay, it is going to send the army. It is going to send the antibodies. Okay, aisa to nahi bouncer ja raha hai sab kuch. You need a revision. So go through it again and again. Okay, next. 20% left mein gaya. Yahaan pe kis liye aaya? Kyunki yahaan se kya gaya tha? Biomolecules, ions or pathogen. तो पैथोजन रिमूव होना चाहिए ना. पैथोजन रिमूव होने के बाद, फॉरेन एलिमेंट रिमूव होने के बाद, वो फिर से आएगा ब्लड में विद टू डक्ट्स, दैट इज द लेफ्ट डक्ट, लेफ्ट लिम्फैटिक डक्ट एंड द राइट थोरैसिक डक्ट. ओनली टू डक्ट्स आर प्रेजेंट. ठीक है, फिर से आएगा. सो दिस इज द मेन डिफरेंस बिटवीन द ब्लड एंड द कैपिलरीज. यू आर गोइंग टू अटेम्प्ट दिस क्वेश्चन and you are going to send me the pic of it. And about the double circulation also, which we attempted today. I hope so this class must be helpful to you all. Okay, we are going to continue this NCRT exercises in the next class. Thank you.